So how many of you use social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram to get some of your news? So clearly, social media has really changed the way we get news. Now, when breaking news hits, everyone runs to their social media accounts to get more information about the event. This has also changed the role of journalists in this era of breaking news or social media news, because we're no longer the news breakers as much, but we still need to spread the truth in an era where anyone can post online. So, according to the August 2017 poll on Pew Research Center, 74% of internet users get their news from Twitter, and another 68% get their news from Facebook, and those are the top two bars right there. And there are benefits to this because news can spread faster and everything is shared at a rapid pace, but sometimes the information being shared can be false. This is where journalists come in. They have to help users navigate the overload of information on the internet. Today, I'm going to talk to you guys about the costs and benefits of getting news on social media and the new role of journalists in the age where anyone can become an eyewitness reporter. So, the increasing popularity of social media since the 2000s has led to the development of citizen journalism, where the average user can become an eyewitness and break news when it happens, even sometimes before news networks and organizations. Citizen journalism, as described by Axel Burns in the essay Blogs, Twitter, and Breaking News, was previously meant as setting up a personal blog or contributing to existing sites on a regular basis. And this requires a lot more work than just setting up a Twitter account. Also, the short messaging services on Twitter has allowed people to contribute to any type of topic with ease, and it leads some topics to become more viral. Hashtags are also used in breaking news situations and allow people to find more about a topic. Some users even become dedicated to following a certain hashtag and have a better understanding of the subject, if what they're reading is correct. And according to the American Press Institute, in a survey conducted in 2015, nearly 86% of Twitter users use the platform when news breaks, while only 74% use it daily. For journalists, however, Twitter is now a place to post breaking news updates as well as publicized stories, so they can completely engage with their audience and the community on Twitter. This new collaboration between journalists and the average citizen allows news to spread faster and helps users navigate the understanding of news. So although it's much easier to get news, there are multiple dangers to getting news from social media accounts. First, all accounts aren't necessarily news organizations and tend to spread fake news and incorrect facts. Users can post whatever they want, whenever they want, and don't have people confirm their claims. So essentially, they could just be posting their opinions. For example, during the Las Vegas shooting, Twitter accounts posted incorrect information about the shooter. So, like, this tweet was completely incorrect, but it was posted on the internet anyways and went viral because people thought that it would be correct information. So, according to the New York Times, in an article about misinformation in the wake of the Vegas shooting, social media users falsely identified the shooter and victims, as well as made up connections to ISIS. So after Mashable, another news website, reached out to a user who posted this fake news and asked why he posted it, the user replied, "For the retweets." So a majority of Twitter users are not journalists and are not worried about the unethical act of spreading fake news. So they're willing to retweet anything just to become popular or get the profile out there. So even though social media has revolutionized the way we communicate, it's also made it much easier to change facts and spread rumors. The role of journalists has also changed to accommodate the advancement of social media. Now it's our job to make sure...
Oh, it might have been on too long. You could just go turn it back on.
Now journalists have to make sure that the information being spread is correct because they're not always the people to break the news, so the information that is being spread on the internet isn't necessarily right. In the Mashable article published in 2017 by Brett Williams, the author gives readers multiple ways to avoid spreading fake news, which I would have on the slide, but it's not loading, so I'm just going on. So first, you have to know who your source is. Because Twitter is open to everyone, so it could be just be someone that's looking for retweets and not reporting facts. Second, if you see a fact that stands out, make sure to fact check it with reliable sources like news organizations. And lastly, think before you share things with the world. Because chances are everything's going to be out there forever. So whether it's retweeting something about news or just sharing a picture, make sure you think before you share it. As a journalism major and hopefully a future journalist, it's somewhat troubling to see people doubt news sources and claim that journalism is dying. But after researching this for the speech, I realized that we need journalism now more than ever. The future of journalism is to help verify facts and make sure important newsworthy articles appear at the top of social media timelines. In the age of fake news, people still need to trust organizations like CNN, who spent years building a credible reputation. And during an interview for the International News Media Association, Yusuf Omar, senior reporter at CNN, explained how the role of journalists has changed, highlighted the fact that we still need journalists, claiming that in the age of social media, in the age of mobile journalism, what we need are editors, journalists, and people that can help us make sense of all the noise. So, although it can be dangerous, social media is a tool for spreading information and getting facts faster. In the end, journalists, like myself, have to embrace the advancement of technology and media and adapt to this new direction that journalism is going in. Thank you.